So now that I have completed the setup, I'm going to run through the 9 points, only saying how I feel. I'm feeling frustrated. Why are we doing this while tapping? Is to allow ourselves to feel the emotion. We have already told ourselves it's okay that we are feeling like this and I still love myself. Now we're saying I'm feeling frustrated while tapping. So that's tapping on the top of your head, preferably for a few seconds, to get yourself adjusted and to release that wherever the cells are holding all of that stress. Then the eyebrow point, I'm feeling frustrated. Again, you say it out loud. At least it's recommended that you say it out loud. If you say it in your mind, it's still fine, but make sure that you actually say that sentence. Make it as specific as possible. Don't keep it very generic and you won't have as much results as you would like. So I'm feeling frustrated. Side of the eye, I'm feeling frustrated. Feel the frustration, it's fine. If you feel like crying, you feel like shouting, you feel like jumping all over the floor, go ahead. The point of tapping is to allow yourself the freedom. Like it's called EFT, Emotional Freedom Technique. You first allow yourself the freedom to feel that emotion and then you are free of that emotion. So side of the eye, I'm feeling frustrated. Under the eye, I'm feeling frustrated. Right now, we're just repeating a very simple statement. You can make it as specific as you want. You can make it as pointed as you want. I'm feeling frustrated because of XYZ. But make sure that you're not pointing it out at a different person, saying, this person did this. The focus should be on, this is how I am feeling. So all my sentences, if you notice, would only be about, I am feeling frustrated. I am feeling that my body is undergoing stress. I feel. That should be your entire motivation. So under the eye, I'm feeling very frustrated. Under the nose, I'm feeling frustrated. Make sure that you are tapping enough number of times at each point. Don't skip any of them. And it's okay to take your time through each point. The next point is your chin. I'm feeling frustrated. Don't expect immediate results while you're still going through the tapping motions. Allow yourself whatever comes up. If the emotion changes and you notice that, excellent, go for the next emotion that comes up. So for me, the frustration is sort of releasing, but a little bit of anger is still simmering in there. So I'm going to shift it just to give you a little bit of a sense of how it works and say, I'm a little angry. Not very angry. I was very frustrated. Now I'm a little angry. The next point, collarbone. I'm a little angry. Now, what happens for a lot of people is, especially when it comes to the collarbone area or the chest area, that's when there is an outpouring of emotions. So allow yourself to breathe through them. Allow yourself to feel them. Take a minute while you're still tapping. If different emotions come up, if different thoughts come up, different memories come up, allow them, continue tapping away. You have already told yourself that even though I am feeling like this, I wholly and completely love and accept myself. So that will carry you through the entire tapping process. And the last point, side of the arm. I was feeling a little frustrated. Now I'm feeling a little angry. Now a thought occurs to me. You know, maybe it's not that bad. And I'll get over it. And whatever happens, I'll manage. Because I have already done the setup and I have told myself I love myself. I'm not dependent on anything else happening. I'm not dependent on feeling a certain way to love myself. Now, this is just running through the points once. It's good to loop these nine pressure points over and over again, at least 3-4 sequences, saying whatever it is that you feel, whatever you experience, whatever comes up for you at that moment, until you feel a certain shift. Okay. So let's say I have run through all of these points after the side of the arm, I go back to the top of my head and continue tapping and verbalizing out loud or in my mind very strongly, this is what I am feeling. When the thought changes and it becomes, you know what, maybe it's not so bad. Or the thought becomes, or the emotion goes from very something something to less something something. Pause, take a breath, allow yourself to relax, allow the body to relax, because it can be tiresome that you have moved your arm in circular motion a lot. You may not be used to so much exercise, so it's good exercise for you. There's also a lot of blood flowing through your system. Allow that to happen. Observe what is going on in your body. Observe your breathing. Now, take stock again. On that scale of 1 to 10, I started out on a 6, feeling frustrated. How do I feel now? It's better, it's at an 8. And I'm being extraordinarily honest with you. My level for going around doing work, I would label myself 10 when I'm ecstatic, which means an 8 is an excellent improvement from a 6, because I'm no longer frustrated. I am calming down. An 8 for me personally is a very good point for me to go about the rest of my day and continue whatever it is that I want to do. Another way that you can also use it is that while this stressful situation is going on, and you don't even have the words for it, but you can bring up the emotion for it, it's a good time to start tapping away. Okay? So all of the chemicals, the hormones, everywhere in your cells, in your blood, in the 70% water that you are, wherever all of these experiences and emotions have been stored, over time they will start to release. So please do drink a lot of water so that you're helping your body flush all of the toxins out of your system. Breathing exercises along with EFT help a lot. Just take deep breaths. This tends to be one of the simplest tools that is in existence that addresses very specifically what you're feeling at that point in time and what is the wisdom that you can take. Now, what I have run you through is a very generic process, right? We just do the setup and we just say, this is how I'm feeling, this is how I'm feeling, and we tap it through. When you do meet a professional and you go through an entire run for whatever stress that you are undergoing or whatever stress that has happened to you in the past or that you are stressed out about that may happen in the future, there are a lot more components that occur that will help you consciously also focus on the fact that these are all the good things that can happen, and then reaffirm to yourself that I am confident, I am fun. I am peace, I am calm. When we run through this entire gamut and every aspect, as it is called, or to use jargon, that's when you start to notice, maybe let's say 15 minutes, half an hour, significant improvement over the situations that you are worried about or that you are concerned about. When you go back, let's say, I have been feeling frustrated about the video that we've been shooting. Tomorrow, let's say I have another video to shoot. When I do go back to that, again, do a rating on the scale of 1 to 10. You may find to your surprise that you're not feeling as excited, that you are feeling more excited, but you're not as stressed out about what is going to happen because you've dealt with it. And that is the point of stress busting, dealing with it, not being afraid of the fact that there may be something that ends up being stressful. So please do call us, do participate with us, do communicate with us. If you would like to have a more in-depth EFT, emotional freedom technique, or a tapping practice run for you, if you would have something very specific that you are looking at, any kind of stress busting, for the long term that you are looking at, please do connect with us through HealthLink.